With the iPod, Apple upped the design stakes and brought a new simplicity to music players. Going digital freed the industry to play with the look and feel of devices. But it's not just the 30-something male readers of Stuff magazine who have bought the latest iPods. Women, kids, even old fogey dads like me have sported the famous white earphone. While Apple were the established cool outsider brand, I wonder if the iPod's success was also down to its advertising. Robin White is a leading ad man who spent years researching advertising psychology.
Robin, when I think of iPod advertising, this is the advert I think of, this silhouette campaign. Why was this so important?
These are brilliant. First of all, you've got this signalling of the white wire. Now, a big part of this young people's market is you're trying to signal, you know, your success, your cool, about basically genetic fitness.
So, through having an iPod, they're saying, I am good breeding stock.
That you're exactly doing that at an unconscious level, and sometimes at a conscious level, you're signalling because you can afford this display activity, and you're actually signalling peacock's tail behaviour, signalling your genetic fitness, and it is the mating game.
How big do you think my iPod is?
Well, your iPod, I'm sure you have the very latest one, it's the exact size, probably, a small one may be more status than a big one, at least in iPods.
And is it as crude as I want to be that person?
Well, one of the points is you don't see who the person is, so you can be that person.
But so I could slot into that
silhouette. You can identify with it. It's the concept of the incomplete proposition. It's called the Zargonic effect. If you have something that's incomplete, you complete the circle, which your brain will do, then it's much more engaging.
So, in your opinion, with an upgraded product, is that product a response to our need for an upgraded product, or is it simply that the companies need to keep selling us things?
Well, it's a mixture of the two, but the company's need to keep selling you things wouldn't work if there wasn't this underlying need. People need, for the functional and the signalling part, the upgrades, and it drives human progress. You should be happy, because if humans didn't want to upgrade, we'd probably still be in the Middle Ages. No one cares, so I'm this high, got
Apple and clever advertising psychology certainly helped drag music out of the Middle Ages. But it's interesting that today, the biggest player in consumer electronics is not in the United States or even in Japan. They're here, in South Korea, at the cutting edge of the digital revolution.
I just peeled myself out of the aeroplane after a 10-hour flight, but the sun's coming up on a new country for me. It's very exciting, and I'm heading to Gadget HQ in Gadget City, in Gadget Country. So I feel as if I'm right in the epicenter of the technological revolution, and it's exciting.
South Korea is one of the world's most advanced digital societies. The capital city, Seoul, is home to Samsung, today the world's largest consumer electronics company. Their global sales have overtaken Sony's and competitors like Toshiba and Panasonic. This is Samsung's swanky new headquarters. The company make an extraordinary diverse range of gadgets, with products for every conceivable and some inconceivable occasions. Illuminati. In 2007, their global consumer electronics sales reached a staggering $105 billion. Inside the HQ is Samsung Delight, a glistening multimedia display promoting the creative philosophy of the company. My guide is Seon Mi Jin.
Watch your step. Samsung Delight has 3 floors, and now we are going to the first floor. And first floor, there are 3 kinds of genres: image, text, and sound.
Image, text, and sound.
And it's also kinds of marketing.
The atmosphere is post-postmodern, but one you can touch and play with, an otherworldly high-tech palace of the senses.
What have we got here?
Oh, yes. Now you see the our MP3 player.
Oh, there are MP3 players?
Yes.
Looks very light.
Yes. Would you like to pick up? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It really
weighs
light.
Nothing, does it?
So it's a sort of pebble-shaped iPod type thing.
Yes, there could be.
Yeah.
Yes.
Why would Samsung design something in the shape of a pebble?
We designed like a pebble because it is easy to grip and easy to hold and really a small one.
It's sort of beautiful as well,
yes,
isn't it?
Yes.
Is that the idea, to appeal to people's sense of beauty?
Sure, yeah. So it's really popular for young people especially. And we also have a pebble design for DVD players.
Because a lot of the original gadgets were quite ugly, weren't they? But they were useful. But it seems now almost as if they're becoming jewelry and ornament.
Oh, yes, sure. Yes. That could be also one idea with these MP3 players.
Yeah.
Walking around the exhibition is a calm and inviting experience. It's design that wants us to engage and be at one with it. Samsung's business is to create the products of tomorrow and to anticipate our desires. Everything is lightweight and pleasing to the eye.
What's very clear looking at these products is that function is no longer a primary concern. We all know that these things work. It's about fashion now. It's about design. It's about decoration. It's about beauty. Who knows? It could even be about art.
Six floors above the showroom, Samsung's mobile phone design team are brainstorming next season's phones. Each year, they're responsible for designing dozens of new models.
So, 이제 세대가 터치 세대로 바뀌면서 충분히 삼성이 먼저 시작했잖아요, 워치폰 같은 경우는. 그거에 대해서 LCD를 얼마큼 사이즈 쓸 것인지, 어떤 베네핏이 있을 것인지에 대한 그걸 우리 나름대로 다음 프로젝트로 정리를 해도 괜찮을 것 같아요. 거기다가.
Surprisingly, they use literary notions to inspire their discussion with enigmatic team leader Elliot. Ideas like stories, emotion, and identity.
우리가 보는 것보다 중요한 게 느껴야 되잖아. 그러니까 뭐 집어 와가지고 감동 가지고 디자인을 해야 되는데 그 뭐 본 거 가지고 하려면 사진 찍고 지금.
The biggest trend in consumer electronics is convergence, gadgets that can do a multitude of things. The team's latest design is an upmarket touchscreen phone combined with camera, MP3 player and internet access.
Actually, design something is like a journey for finding this kind of new story, new kind of emotion for the people. So they want to express their lifestyle with this, you know, very stylish phone, especially in the back. The back size is more important, you know, it's getting more important these days. Because
so through the back of the phone, because that's projecting towards other people, you're signaling to other people what sort of person you are.
That's right, that's right.
And what sort of person would I be if I had this phone? Would I be cool, smart?
Both, I think.
Sexy?
Absolutely.
And next year, will there be a better phone than this?
Absolutely. Because design trend is changing and people's emotion is also changing.
Does Korea have a huge appetite for new phones?
It's kind of testbed for new design, new technologies. So every time when we, you know, introduce new phones, people really like that. Sometimes having old phone here is kind of very strange.